Hello, hello, hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to continue watching Supernatural. We are in season 4 and at episode 6, and I am extremely excited to watch this because gosh, has it been difficult to wait this long. If you are new here, hello, welcome in. My name is Cora. It is so lovely to have you here. I'm also a Twitch streamer and I create gaming content here on YouTube. If you want to check my gaming content out, you can click the link up here. And if you want to come and hang out live or check out any of my other social media, the link that is down below in the description box. And if you're not new, welcome, welcome back. So I've been gone for a few weeks and I'm very sorry that I haven't posted anything about it, but I've been going through a very difficult time. There's been a lot of things that's happened behind the scenes in my life, and that has also affected a chronic illness that I have, which has just been a whole lot of everything, and work has been busy, and I wasn't sure when I was gonna feel ready to do this again, so I didn't want to send any message and bring any like specific date up. I was a little bit scared to do that, and these things are a little bit sensitive. You know, everyone who does content on the internet are in the end of the day just humans, and sometimes it's difficult to talk about these things, and sometimes it's difficult to share these things about yourself for various reasons. But I haven't been able to record for many reasons, and I haven't been able to answer any comments or doing anything, but I am hoping that I'm gonna feel okay enough to get right back into this. So here I am recording today. I want to say thank you to everyone who reached out and who is very kind about it, and thank you for not pressuring me into anything. I know how the internet can be, so I just want to say thank you. And for those who are still here, despite the fact that I just disappeared for a little bit, thank you for still being here. I really do appreciate that. And once again, I am very sorry for doing that, but I had to do what was best for me in the moment to make sure that I still feel like myself, and I needed to prioritize my own health, which I think most of you will be able to understand, but thank you for doing so. Without talking about this for like years, because I feel like it's very uninteresting, let's talk about the last episode. So I had a little like peek at what happened the last episode, which honestly I didn't really need much of like a reminder of what happened, because it was a very different episode. It stood out a lot from other episodes. The last one was fully in black and white, and we had a shapeshifter who turned into different monsters from the movies to kind of try to change the destiny for himself, for him not wanting to be a monster and everything that he's gone through. He got obsessed with monster movies and instead turned into these monsters in hopes of like turning the monsters good and making the story different, which doesn't make sense because, you know, he still killed people and kidnapped a woman and all of that stuff. But in this dude's head, I guess that is what made sense. It was a little bit sad when he told them what his father had done to him and stuff like that. So it was tragic in a sense, which I feel like it is a lot of the time. But overall, it was a pretty silly, goofy episode. The fact that it was shot in black and white took me completely off guard. It was fun that they did something new. I'm sure there's a lot of people who probably thought that was weird and maybe didn't even like it, but I thought that it was quite funny to see it from that perspective, because you really wanted to see how immersed the character was into these movies, and I feel like it kind of portrayed that. It was a lot of funny comments. There was a lot of what comments that also flew over my head as per usual, but a lot of you answered those afterwards, so now I feel like I understand that episode way more. It was funny, it was a bit of a sidetrack episode, special episode. I liked it, it was funny. It wasn't the best I've ever seen, but I still enjoyed it. Honestly, I've enjoyed most episodes so far. It's difficult not to like them, even when they're not like up here, if that makes sense. I have kind of lost track a bit, so I really do not know what to expect from this one, but I also expect that, like, as soon as I start watching, I'm gonna be thrown into everything, back at it again, and I guess we're just gonna have to, go straight for it and hope for the best. So without further ado, let's get into the episode. I was just gonna say, is that Dean? Is it bad that I was able to hear that it was potentially Dean from just the sound he makes when he's running? Oh god. Are we gonna deal with like a werewolf here or?
Run! It'll kill you!
Cutest little puppy you've ever seen. Why is it chasing him though? Okay, I have to admit, I did not see that coming. Rock Ridge, Colorado. Ah, 43 hours earlier. Okay, so we're getting the backstory.
Where you meet Frank O'Brien.
But O'Brien was 44 years old, and according to this, a marathon runner.
Everybody drops dead sooner or later.
Ah.
Now, just yesterday, two perfectly healthy men visited Malmö. All heart attacks. You don't think that's strange?
Why does the FBI give a damn anyway?
Well, the FBI is sneaky with what they do, huh?
Popsy.
The one you're gonna do.
What topsy? Well.
First dead body.
Floor of Roman.
Hey, hand me those rib cutters.
Okay, I'm a little bit scared. Why do they help? Like, this is okay. I'm like, should they be conducting anything, even if they were FBI, should they be touching the utensils in an autopsy?
I didn't think Frank was married.
Any idea how we got these?
You know what? Oh
my.
Yes, tend to drop.
Yeah, but how does it scrape up that much from him? Well, I guess if he was like in a slurp, he could get that kind of damages, but like if he was just standing on normal ground. Oh my god, that sound!
That's pretty damn healthy. Hold it a second.
Sam's just laughing at it. Well, I guess he got his. He's like, you know what? I'll happily hold this heart. Why am I cry laughing? I'm smudging my makeup already. I'm not even crying.
Who are they?
Federal agent.
Yeah, it just felt weird that, like, if he just dropped from a heart attack, that he would scrape his arm that much, is what I was trying to say.
Shoes off.
Wait. What? Is that a thing? Taking your shoes off? That's not a thing, right? That's gonna be a his office kind of thing? Interesting. Well, you know what? Yep, like that I was gonna say. Well, it's good to be clean, sanitary, especially in these times.
What can I do for Uncle Sam?
Well, we're looking into the death of Frank O'Brien.
Uncle Sam?
We're friends.
Oh.
Hell, we were Gamecocks.
Why is he laughing at that?
Softball team's name.
He's like, oh, yeah, okay.
They're majestic.
Now I see.
Animals.
This was not the time, Dean.
He was a good man.
Yeah. Big heart.
Dean, did you have to?
Acting strange. Maybe scared of something.
Oh, hell yeah. Real
no?
jumpy.
You know what scared him?
No.
Okay, so he's coughing and cleaning excessively?
No, it's probably nothing.
And now he's acting strange. Do they get paranoid? Because he was jumpy and he seems to be like extremely clean. Right? Like excessively, sorry.
Ghosts, vampires, chupacabra? It could be 100 things.
Chupacabra? What is that?
Hey, what? I don't like the looks of those teenagers down there. Let's walk this way.
Wait, what? Isn't that his? Huh? Why would he be scared of teenagers? I don't understand. Dean wouldn't be scared of teenagers, right? And they looked like super chill.
Did you speak to him recently? Did he seem different?
scared?
Oh, totally. He was freaking out.
Oh? Oh, no. First the teenagers, now all of the animals?
Yeah, witches.
Witches.
Wait.
Wizard of Oz was on TV the other night, right?
Oh.
And he said that green bitch was totally out to get him.
Okay, that is very interesting.
Scare him?
Everything else scared him.
So tell me, what was Frank like?
He got better.
He got better?
In high school, he was a dick.
A dick?
Like a bully.
I see. Okay, it does kind of sound like a dick. I see, yeah.
Wanted to get revenge?
Well, I don't.
He's like, attack, right? Hang on. You targeting me?
He got better. And after what happened to his wife.
His wife?
Oh, flip.
He died about 20 years ago.
Oh, okay, so not recent. I thought it was recent. I was like, did she die from the same cause?
Don't be scared of Donnie. He's a sweetheart.
Donnie.
It's Marie you gotta look out for. She smells fear.
You know what? I would freak out too, Dean. I'll give you that. It is weird that you're freaking out over, not the snakes, but the teenagers. But I would freak out if there was a snake. I hate to admit, snakes can be really cute, but they terrify me. They're really scary.
Frank's wife, Jessie, was a manic depressive. She went off her med back in 88 and vanished. They found her 2 weeks later, three towns over, strung up in her motel room, suicide.
Oh, that's horrible. Oh, I cannot.
Search the top to bottom. No EMF, no hex bags, no sulfur. So probably no ghosts, no witches, no demons.
Probably not.
Dude, you're going 20. And that's the speed limit.
What, he's like, this is not used to you. Used to you. This is not how you usually are. Okay, now this is making me confused. The police officer seemed a little paranoid, okay? With scrubbing his hand twice, taking off his shoes whilst at work. At home, I don't think that's weird, but it's a little strange of work, you know? And the teenagers, and now the animals, and now the speed limit, and now the EMF is going off.
Am I on it?
Am I on it? To be fair, being haunted is scary, but I feel like he wouldn't usually freak out that much, right? The music. Wait, is it weird the car is there? Wait, why is that straight? Oh. All the music is of course coming from his car. Oh gosh.
Look at this.
Oh god, no! That he did that, didn't he? Himself. Because he was scratching the other night with the paper, right? He scratched. Yeah. He might have done it himself. God. Wait, Gorse sickness? What the heck is Gorse sickness? Yeah, he's like, oh god. Oh god, I don't know what that is.
Symptoms are you get anxious, then scared.
Oh, yep.
Then really scared, then you're
heart. Yeah. Okay, the symptoms make sense.
I haven't seen a ghost in weeks. I doubt you caught it from a ghost. Look, once the spirit infects that first person, ghost sickness can spread like any sickness.
Oh, no.
He was the first to die, which means he was probably the first infected. Patient zero. Frank was in Maumee over the weekend. Softball tournament. Which is where he must have infected the other two.
Oh, no. Gamecocks, corn jerkers? What names are those?
Corpse? Right. So now what? I have 48 hours before I go and say...
But wait, why didn't Sam get it then?
More like 24.
24 hours! Like, we haven't been dealing with him almost dying? Yeah, I was gonna talk about the spleen juice.
Turns out all three victims shared a certain, personality type.
I'm not following?
They were all dicks.
Oh.
So you're saying I'm a dick? No. And now this disease is just returning to
face. Are you saying I'm a dick? I can't.
I mean, all we do is scare people. Okay, well then you're a dick too. Apparently I'm not.
He's like, well, I'm not a dick because I didn't get infected. Well, it is good because imagine the two of them getting infected. They would be running around like headless chickens.
Our room's on the fourth floor. It's high.
He's like, yeah.
See if I can move us down to the first. Thanks. Sure.
Oh no, so bad for him. Dean's... Oh, that's definitely very un-Dean-like. Is he not gonna dare eating those either? Oh, flip. Poor him. Oh, no. Oh, and now he's reading stuff and now he's imagining that he feels that way. Oh, God. The psyche really sucks sometimes. No, poor Dean. He's like reading all of these words. Okay, maybe close that book. Did he just break the... Yeah, he did. Sounds like, what did the clock ever do to you?
Just peachy. Find anything?
Yeah.
It is so odd seeing him like this.
So I'm pretty sure she is not our ghost. Hey, quit picking at that.
Yeah. Okay, so it was probably himself scratching.
Okay.
Oh, flip. Oh, is he scared that he's gonna get something stuck in his throat and so he does? Or... What the?
What the? We've been completely ignoring the biggest clue we have. You.
Huh?
I don't want to be a clue.
The abrasions, the disease...
I don't want to be a clue.
Tells what, wood chips?
What do you mean exactly? I hope I'm not the only one lost here. And also, how did he get a wood chip? Like, how did he swallow that big of a wood chip without noticing? Wouldn't you feel that? At least?
I'm not going in there. I need backup, and you're all I've got.
It might not be the best backup currently, I will say. Why are you That would make things worse, though. If you're drunk, then it would be... Oh, well, it would take the edge off, I guess, but it would be also worse in terms of balance and stuff, right? It's so weird seeing Dean being like, yeah, this is a little scary, right?
Oh, I'm not carrying that. It could go off.
He's like, you carried so many guns before.
You do that.
He's like, thank you. Great. You're really helpful right now. I know I shouldn't be laughing. I feel bad for him. As a person who's also really anxious, I feel for him. But it's just funny seeing him that way, okay? It's just very out of character. Is he gonna get really scared because that one's going off now? How did they find his place? Have they been here before?
EMF's not gonna work with me around, is it?
He's like hoping that he can leave, right? Tiny thing and they get scared. Oh!
To Frank. Love, Jesse.
Frank. That's Frank's ring. Okay. Oh, so did he go here and get infected? Well, that would make sense, but how was the wood piece a clue and how did Dean get the wood piece in it? That part I'm a little lost on, okay? Maybe I'm just out of touch with the logic of Supernatural. Oh my god, he looks terrified! Oh no, he's like shaking!
That was scary!
I'm so sorry, I'm like, God! It's Sam's face as well, just like, I cannot with you. Oh, I should not be laughing. Oh, poor Dean. I mean, that would be me, so like, it's not like I blame him or try to. It's just, it's Dean we're talking about, okay? It's weird seeing him like this.
Luther Garland. Hey, this is,
Is that his wife?
This is Frank's wife.
Wait, did she die here? Oh, flip. How did that... Yeah, this isn't creepy at all. I would run. Oh, God. Oh, there he is. love that Dean is just holding the line, not saying anything. Oh, he just ran. I don't blame him. I would run too. It's just poor Dean. I just want to give him a hug and a pat on the back.
I guess we got the right place.
Oh my god, he's sweating as well. Oh no. They better hurry up though.
Is he drunk?
No.
No.
Luther Garland's cause of death was physical trauma.
Probably a little drunk, extremely anxious and terrified.
Before my time. Sorry.
Then can we talk to the sheriff?
He's out sick today.
Well, if you see him.
Oh, shouldn't this give them warning signs, though, if the sheriff isn't there?
You're awesome.
He's like, yeah, okay, thank you. You're not at all drunk.
You too, I guess.
Yeah, that was not an awkward conversation.
What do they want?
A file, Luther Garland's. Sheriff?
Oh no. Oh my god, what did he just scrub himself with?
They know.
Oh my god. Oh dude, that's gonna be such a bad way to go. Wait, what you did? Like being a dick, what you did?
This isn't gonna work. Like, come on, these badges are fake. What if we get busted? We could go to jail.
Does he say now? Like, this has never occurred to you before.
Just come on.
It's funny. It shouldn't be. It's horrible as well. I just cannot get over the picture of him scratching himself.
I'm Agent Tyler. This is Agent Perry, FBI.
Wait.
I'd like to ask you a few questions about your brother Luther.
Oh, I was like, but he was dead, wasn't he?
Certainly.
Oh my god, Dean is gonna blow their cover. He's so nervous.
Those are real. Obviously.
He's like, Dean, what are you doing? He's like, can you just not say anything at the moment?
According to this, your brother Luther...
It has been something that I have felt. It's a little stressful, though. The fact that... that they've been going around with those. But I guess most people don't know the difference.
We're just trying to get the truth on your brother.
Everybody's scared of Luther. They called him a monster. He was too big, too mean looking.
No!
Different.
That's so mean.
He was the kindest man I ever knew.
The cat.
A lot of people fail, Luther. I was one of them.
Oh, he feels bad still about it. I hate when people are so misunderstood. Like that. It's horrible.
It's Jesse O'Brien. Her man Frank killed Luther.
Wait.
Everybody knew him.
What? Why did Frank kill him?
Nice to Luther. He had a crush on him.
Well, you can't kill someone for having a crush on someone.
Frank was sure.
Oh.
Done something to him.
I'm getting.
Out killed herself. Frank didn't know that.
So he killed. Oh my god, no! Just because of the way he looks and is, he assumed it was him. Okay, yeah, this does not look good, though. At all. Oh, that's horrible. It is creepy that he's drawing so many pictures of her, but just because he's a little different, you can't assume that he... No. No, he didn't do that.
Chain wrapped around his neck. He was dragged up and down the stretch outside that plant.
No, that's horrible.
I screamed to every cop in town. They were looking to Frank. He was a pillar of the community.
My brother. And because he was their friends, right? No, this is so sad.
Life's too short for hate, son. If Frank wasn't thinking straight. His wife had vanished. He was terrified.
No, yeah, I get that, but you killed someone.
That's fear. It spreads and spreads.
Oh my god, don't say that with Dean there.
Now I know what these are. Road rash. And I'm guessing Luther swallowed some wood chips when he was being dragged down that road. Experiencing his death in slow motion.
That's what's happening. That's what the wood chip was.
Dean, it won't be that easy.
No, it'll be that easy. Why won't it be that easy?
His body was ripped to pieces. He was probably scattered all over that road. There's no
way all the remains. So what do you do?
Just have to figure something else out.
And Dean's not gonna be any help of this. please.
Ghost, exactly. Who does that? Us. Right. And that's exactly why our lives suck. We search out things that want to kill us. Yeah? Huh?
He's not wrong, you know.
We
and
are
yeah.
insane. You know, then there's the diner food and then the scheming.
Not insane, room. Maybe though.
I mean, who wants this life, Sam? Huh? Seriously.
You do, though.
Being stuck in a car.
Kinda. Not really, but kinda.
Day? I don't think so. I mean, I drive too fast and I listen to the same 5 albums over and over and over. And you.
Oh, no.
You eat half a burrito when you get toxic. I mean, you know what?
No, I can't. I love that Sam is just like.
I'm done with it. I'm done with the monsters and the hellhounds and the ghost sickness and the damn apocalypse.
Sam is handling this so well, though. I mean, he knows what's up, so, like, I get it, but he's just like, okay, you're gassy. It's just so funny. Oh, and here we have the dog. I see.
I looked everywhere for you, Dean. How the hell did you get here?
He ran.
Ran?
He said that too. Oh. Sam's like, oh, it's just, oh my god.
What do we do now? I got less than 4 hours on the clock.
You breathe, and, oh my god, no.
Back? Downstairs.
Oh, now I see. He's imagining that Sam's saying this to... Oh, yeah. Hallucinations.
A real pain in my ass.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
This is what I'm going to become. This is what I want.
All of his worst fears are just thrown at him. And he's probably... Oh, God. Yeah.
Ding.
Oh, God. Poor Dean. Oh, he's terrified. How do you handle that? Oh, my God. No. Because they're paranoid, too, right? Is he gonna assume that that's true now? Is he gonna see... Oh, fudge. Is he gonna think that Sam's actually a demon now? Oh, God. Oh, no, why did you leave him at home?
Oh, have his hallucinations started yet?
Yeah, a few hours ago.
Ah, Janelle.
You can read Japanese?
Kimi no kumareru maikara zutto dayo.
Guess so. Show off.
Okay, Bobby, show off.
It infects people with fear. It's called a buru-buru.
See how to kill it?
Same as usual. Burn the remains.
Yeah.
Plan B?
Well, the buru-buru is born of fear. You can kill it with fear.
So we have to scare
it. Kill it with fear? How do you scare a goat to death? What the? Yeah.
Just ride off the trip, okay? You're gonna be fine. We got a plan.
What is it?
Just a good plan, alright?
Just a really good plan that I'm not gonna tell you because you're really not gonna believe this is a good plan because we barely don't.
Yeah, tell me about it. I know
it really is.
Death, but this? Hey, you got a better idea. I'm listening.
He's like, point taken. That's usually when they resort to the really bad plans. That's when there is no other plan in sight. Oh, I really hope they don't have to scare... What was he called? Luther? To death? Oh, they probably do, right? That's... He doesn't deserve that, though, right? Didn't he deserve to go to rest peacefully? He didn't actually do anything wrong, right? Flippin' heck. Oh, is it the hellhounds that he's seeing now? Oh, flippin' heck. Oh, what the? Oh no, this is not good.
Why are you looking into Luther Garland's death?
Oh, he's been covering it up. That's why he's... That's what the voices were saying. And now he's nervous because they're looking into... Oh,
so he made flip. A mistake. So I didn't bust him. So what?
They're not trying to bring you down. Oh. Oh. Okay, that reflex kind of worked in his favor in the end. Oh, no. Oh, you gotta hurry so that both of them can preferably stay alive. Oh no, now he thinks he's a demon. Oh, this is not getting any better, is it?
Ow, you gotta calm down.
Get back!
Oh, maybe him seeing this will help him stay calm? Or maybe it will do the opposite, never mind. Not great, is it? What is he gonna do about the fact that he has the sheriff dead in his room?
It's almost like he's, scared.
Oh, he's probably been scared his entire life, and he's probably scared even as a ghost, too. Oh.
Hey, Luther!
He doesn't deserve it! I know that he's dead already, but I just wish he could just go to rest in peace. Maybe this is the only way to get him to rest in peace, though, I guess. Uh-oh. How do you plan on scaring him, though? Dean, stop itching! Stop, 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 stop! Ouch! Well, the fact that he's hearing that in Sam's voice is not making it any better. Oh, I'm getting itchy too just because he's itching so much. What the heck?
Hi, Dean.
Oh my god.
No.
Yes, it's me, Lilith. Oh, I missed you so much.
The fact that they got her, the actress, to come back to the episode too.
What's the matter, Dean? Don't you remember all the fun you had down there?
Oh, it's so freaky.
Once is like 40 years in hell. Like doggy years. And you remember every second.
Oh no. Is she making it? His hallucination of Lilith is making him remember, right?
It doesn't matter. You're still gonna die. You're still gonna burn.
Oh, I still want to know why she has, like, white eyes instead, and why hers gets rolled instead.
You know why, Dean.
Because the others don't, right? They don't... Well, maybe they do roll. Actually, I'm not sure. Oh, this is so, like, the worst thing you could hear if you're anxious. Oh, this is making me stressed. Oh, no. Where's Bobby? Bobby, come in and save the day. You gotta get... You're not supposed to scare Sam. We're supposed to scare Luther. Oh my god, ouch. Oh no, no. No, they're gonna scare him like that. Oh, my heart. I know that this is the only thing that, because they have to hurry, they have to do this. I know, but it just... It feels so wrong. Well, it worked. Thankfully. It just... Oh, this breaks my heart. Does it break it completely then, huh? Right? Hopefully. Oh! Wait, it heals the scratches? Oh, that's interesting. Huh.
So you guys road hauled a ghost.
Yep, they did.
With a chain.
Yep.
Iron chain etched with spell work. Hmm. That's a new one.
Yeah, it is brutal. It was a brutal way to guard.
You sure, Dean? Because this line of work can get awful scary. I'm fine. Oh, you want to go hunt?
Did Sam tell him what he said?
Oh, he's adorable.
Kind of funny.
You boys drive safe. You too, Bobby. Hey, thanks.
Wait, why does this goodbye feel different? Oh, please tell me that's just my weird gut feeling. Nothing is allowed to be happening to Bobby, okay? Nothing.
So what did you see near the end of me?
Is he gonna tell him?
Stop beating my ass? Seriously.
Ooh. What does that mean? No, what does that mean? No!
Just the usual stuff, Sammy.
Oh my god, my heart! It could have said Lily or Lilith or something, but... What was that? Is he still sick or was that actually Sam's eye? Wait, what? What is this? Wait, what? What's happening? Why are we seeing this? What? Oh my god, I can't. Is this a blooper? Did he just do that? Because we're hearing people laugh in the background. I don't know what he's doing, but I'm loving this. Oh, did he just get feeling to jam out to Eye of the Tiger? Oh, he just had to. Oh my god, I love that they kept that in. I can't believe they did, but I'm so happy they kept that in. What a good first episode to get back into the series with. Oh gosh, I missed it so much. I freaking love this show. It just has a special place in my heart. Oh my god, I've been cry laughing this entire episode. Not the normal supernatural crying, just a cry laughing. That bit at the end. That really took me by surprise and I love it. That was so funny. He just went for it. And you know, I love that. I used to jam out to the Eye of the Tiger when I was a teenager because that is obviously what cool teenagers do, right? I feel like it's pretty obvious by now that I was a very cool teenager. At least I pretend I was. Anyway, great episode. I loved it. It was very tragic for a lot of reasons. We had, well, obviously all the people dying from, like, actually getting scared to death. We had the suicide and then Luther who got killed from having a crush on someone's wife and that having a bad timing with her death. And oh, it was horrible. And I hated that they had to, the only way to get rid of him as a ghost was to scare him to death. He really didn't deserve that, but he does deserve to, like, rest in peace. So hopefully after being scared to death, he will. That was absolutely horrible. There was a lot of sad parts and it was... I felt sorry. I know I was laughing, but I felt bad for Dean, okay? It was just... It's just seeing Dean like that, you know? It's... So un-Dean-like. That was... It was a little funny, okay? I know I should not be laughing, but it was a little funny to me. I do hope that you enjoyed this episode. I really enjoyed it. Oh my gosh, I need to know also the eye thing, okay? I almost forgot about it just because they threw that, like, the little blooper behind the scenes stuff thingy at the end. Sam's eyes. That could mean a billion things, okay? It might have something to do with his demon blood, because he also does have yellow-eyed demon's blood specifically in him. But it could also just be Dean's fears festering. I'm assuming he doesn't have the ghost sickness anymore, but it could still be related to that. Fudge in hell, I need to know what that means. Oh, that's so scary. Like, whatever reason there is behind that eye thingy, it's terrifying. Absolutely freaking terrifying. And I need to know. Gosh, this series, it's just, it keeps me on the edge of my seat all the time. and it's always an emotional roller coaster. I'm happy it was a tragic as usual, but also kind of funny episode as a good way to get back into the series, I feel like. Thank you so much for watching today's episode. Thank you for having patience with me. I do hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, it would mean a lot if you wanted to give it a thumbs up. Of course, comment down below your thoughts, emotions, feelings when you watched it, when we watched it. Anything I missed, any fun facts, always love reading them. Thank you so much for being here. I hope that I'll see you in the next one, and I hope that you'll have an amazing rest of your day, night, morning, midnight snack, breakfast, whichever time it is for you when you're watching this, and I'll see you very soon.